in this video, we're going to look at multiplying some monomials by some polynomials. We're going to start off with a pretty simple one here. We've got a monomial, 3, no variables in it, times a nice little binomial here, a squared plus 5. We use the distributive property of multiplication here, which means that we're going to take the monomial up front and we're going to distribute it to every single term inside our polynomial there. 3 times a squared is going to give me 3a squared. And 3 times 5 gives me 15. Okay. We can see that that one's a pretty straightforward one. When we get into some more complex ones with a lot of variables in them, it can look a little bit ugly, but basically we're going to do the exact same thing as we've done before. Distributive multiplication, like we've seen that, and multiplying monomials together. Basically what this boils down to here is we've got two terms. We have two sets of monomials being multiplied together. Let's try one that's a little bit trickier. 2x times x plus 3. Here's our monomial, 2x times x, and then times 3. Two steps. Again, another binomial we're multiplying by. The first one here we've got is 2x times x. Remember back when we're multiplying monomials together, that's what we have here, one monomial times another monomial right now. We multiply the coefficients, 2 times 1 gives us 2, and then we add the exponents, a little 1 gives us x squared. Next step, we're going to multiply 2x times 3. Multiply the coefficients, add the exponents, in which case there are none over here, so we're just going to get 6x. So you can see here, we'll try one in a second. It's got some nice ugly polynomials in it, a lot of variables, but all that we're going to boil down to is things we saw in the multiplying monomials together video. All right, let's try this guy here. Lots of ugly stuff. (3a^5b - 4a^2a + 3b). You might see this on a test or on an assignment, and you might freeze, go, "Oh, what do I do with this? There's six different kind of terms we got here. Well, two terms, a couple other factors, a couple variables, goes up to cubed." It's a lot of stuff, but everything we're going to boil down to here is things we've seen before. Multiplying monomials together once, twice, three times, four times. And then, if we do our multiplication, all we're going to be doing is adding and subtracting monomials, which we've done before as well. 3a cubed times 2a, multiply the coefficients, 6, add the exponents, 4. 3a cubed times negative 5b, remember to include that negative there, or else you're going to make some mistakes. Multiply the coefficients, negative 15, a cubed times b gives us a cubed b. Negative 4a cubed times 2a, multiply the coefficients, add the exponents, and then multiply the coefficients, negative 4 times 3, negative 12, a cubed b. Now we're at the stage where all we're doing is collecting like terms. Look for terms that have the same variables in them, each with the same exponent. a4, collect those two. 6 and negative 8 gives me negative 2, a to the fourth. I've got some a cubed b's here and some more a cubed b's. Negative 15, negative 12 gives me negative 27, a cubed b. That's as far as we can take it. No other like terms to collect. That's multiplying monomials times polynomials. Everything we've done before, multiplying monomials, collecting like terms, it can just look very ugly.